Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Stephanie, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can build an AI-powered flyer generator which you can use to market your product or even generate UGC content for your products. And I'm going to show you how you can do this inside n8n using Google's latest image generation model, Nano Banana, also known as Gemini 2.5 Flash. By the end of this tutorial, you'd have a workflow where all you have to do is upload a product image, provide some details, and then you get your flyer. And then if you decide to customize this further, then you could even have like an ad copy package that is campaign ready. So let's get started. As you can see, this is my workflow here. I'm going to run a quick demo for you so that you have an idea of how this works. And then I'll walk you through the step-by-step on how to build this. So this is the product details form, which I'm starting with. And basically, if I should click on execute workflow, you'd see that I have some filters, and I'll show you how those filters are created. But this is for a Dove skincare lotion. So I'm just going to say Dove lotion. Then I'm going to upload the image, which is this one. And then I'm gonna come in here, enter the main benefits, which I got from Google. Just for the purposes of this tutorial, I'm just like putting in like anything. For target audience, I'm gonna just say female. Brand name, I'm gonna say Dove. And then the product type, I'm gonna say skincare, okay? And I'm gonna click on submit. Okay, so this has been submitted. So I'm gonna run this now and let's see what we get. So as you can see, this is generating the flyer details for us, the prompts we need for the flyer. And then we're gonna transform this, move that into this one. Okay, so this is the file we got. So as you can see, it's generated the image for us and it's storing the image inside our Google Drive folder for us. So I'll show you the image we got inside Google Drive. So the image is now being stored in Google Drive. So let me show you the exact folder. So this is the file that was just generated for us and it's in Google Drive. I'm also gonna drop the template in the description box so that you can download it and try it out and let me know any other functionality you'd like to add to this workflow. Okay, now that you've seen the demo, let me walk you through this workflow so that you could also like build it as well. So as mentioned, I'm starting off with like a form, and this is basically an n8n form. It doesn't have to be a form inside n8n. You could have your own form in, let's say you can use Google Forms, or you could have a form on your website. Really all you need is a form so that you could sort of like upload an image and fill in the details. In this particular form here, I have like the fields as product name, the product image, the main benefits, target audience, and brand name, and then product type. But it doesn't have to be this, okay? These are the fields I used. It really comes down to the type of content you want to generate. It comes down to the product and all that and what you want to do. The reason why I am collecting the data, like the main benefits and everything, is because I want to later on use it to like generate the ad copy and also use it to also generate things to put on the flyer. So up until now, I've just created a form. And once the form is submitted, the data is passed through the fields node. I want to talk a bit about the extract form file. So the Google Nano Banana model would work with like base64 strings and not like the binary file itself. So in order for me to be able to pass this into like the Google Nano Banana model, I have to sort of like move the file to a base64 string. So this is what I've done here. So I'm basically using the extract from file node. And if you come into n8n and you basically search for extract from file, so this is basically the node you are looking for, and it has a lot of options. So depending on whatever you're working with, if you're working with an XML file or an Excel file, then you can really decide what you want to use here. But since I'm working with like a binary file and I want to move it to a base64 file, I'm going to go with this. So this is what I have. So move file to a base64 string. I'm not really putting in much in terms of configuration. I didn't add any like options or anything. All I just did was, because the file that was uploaded was named upload product image, that's what I'm putting in the input binary field. And then the destination, I'm just calling it data. So all these things are things you can sort of customize. You can really decide what you want the destination file to be called. Okay, so once I move this into a base64 string, I come into the edit field node, and you could basically again access the edit field node by clicking on this plus sign and just searching for edit field. You'd see you select this one, and in terms of the configuration here, the reason why I'm just extracting all these is that usually when you submit the form, you get a lot of like data that you probably don't want. If I should come back into my product details form, right, and I come into schema, you'd see that there are so many things that are probably being provided here that I really don't need. So like the size, for instance, I'm not using the size in my model in any way, so I don't need that information. So I basically just want it to be a little more cleaner. So what I'm doing here is that I'm just extracting the things I need, which is really the information that was passed through from the form. So the product name, the main benefits, the target audience, the brand name, those are the main things I'm taking. And also because I can't create like a manual field here and drag the B64 string inside, what I'm gonna say is include other input fields, and I'm just specifically selecting the data field. Okay, so yeah, so once this is done, the next step is where we actually deal with our AI model. Okay, and this time around I'm not using OpenAI, I'm using Gemini, because why not? I'm talking about Google Nano Banana or Gemini 2.5 Flash, so why talk about OpenAI? I chose this exact model because if you've been following the news,
Nano Banana lives. It does. It thrives.
Then you know that Google's Nano Banana definitely lives after the hype. It eats, okay? I know this because I've tried it under various circumstances, tried it with various prompts, and it definitely lives after the expectation and the hype. All right, so I'm using Google Gemini chat model, and in here, I'm using the 2.5 Flash image preview. I noticed that if you don't have like a separate HTTP node for this part of the process, is going to generate like a generic design which really isn't based on the images you uploaded. Okay, so which is why you want to have your own separate HTTP node. Now inside the AI agent, and like I mentioned, I'm going to drop this in the description box as well so that you can download it. But now that I have talked about the templates, let me also talk about my upcoming free n8n crash course on Maven. So on September 15th, I'm having like a 1 hour free session on n8n. So if maybe some of the tutorials I've been doing is too advanced and you're looking for like how to really get started, you want to go back to the basics, then you'd want to join me on that course on Maven. I'm going to leave the link to register for that course in the description box so that you can sign up for that. I also have a subsequent course that is about 3 weeks long. So if you really want to get started with n8n to like becoming a master with that as well, then you'd want to join that other course as well. I'm going to leave the link to both of those two courses in the description box so that you can sign up for that. But yeah, so now that I've talked about my course, let me talk about what's in our AI agent in here. So as a prompt, I'm just saying generate a flyer design, and that's all I'm saying. The reason why I put this AI agent in here is because I wanted to generate the images dynamically. So I could have just simply had like a static prompt. I just want to have like a different image every time, which is why I have this system message here sort of trying to craft like a different prompt that will be passed on to the HTTP node dynamically. So in here, you can also ask the AI agent to like draft an ad copy based on the information that was given in the form. So as you can see, in the form you've added like the product benefits and everything, so you could basically in here ask the model to include an ad copy as well for you, and it will do so. In this tutorial, I just didn't want to sort of complicate it. I just wanted to keep it very simple and just focus on the flyers and the ad copy. Okay, so yeah, this is the task. Like I mentioned, I'm gonna drop the template so you see exactly what I used in the prompt message or in the system message. But basically, I'm saying you are an AI creative director that generates flyer descriptions, and I've given it a task and I've told it not to sound robotic. I've also mentioned that, for instance, if the product is a skincare brand, then maybe have a woman or a man with glowing skin, fresh background, elegant topography. If it's tech, then maybe have like a modern futuristic neon or gradient accent. If it's fitness, then basically have like a gym, outdoor setting. If it's food, you can define something else. Like, you can really decide on how you want this to go. Okay, you don't have to like just restrict yourself to this. And I'm interested in knowing like what else you're gonna build. in addition to this as well. All right, so this is what I have in the AI model here. Now, this is basically where the magic happens. So this is where I'm calling the Google Nano Banana model. Take note of this link. And also you can access this link if you go into the Google documentation for developers and you go into their image generation model and you're looking for like the image editing specifically, then basically this is what you're looking for, right? It gives you the curl code you need for your HTTP node in n8n. So I'm basically using this documentation in here. And so back here, I'm also passing, like, you need to also have like your Google API key set up for Gemini. You also need to have your image. You need to drag the prompt in here. So you need to have like the prompt you need, which is basically this text in here, which was dragged here. You also need to have like the data. So the data is the image which I uploaded, which we converted into a B64 string. So this is what we have in here as well, dragged here. And then this is the output we get. So basically we get an image back, but because this is a B64 image, we can't really understand what this image is. So what we have to do is we have to go ahead and sort of like convert it back into a binary file. So that is what we do here. So in order to convert it back, all you need is to click on this and search for like the convert node, and then it converts to file. If you click on convert to file, you can see that there are so many things you can convert in here. But what we want to do is we want to convert the B64 string to file. So click on that. And then as you can see, the B64 string has now been converted to file. This is the image we got. Guys, do you know how much it would be to get a model to sort of like take photos with your product? It's really expensive. So definitely this saves you a lot of time, saves you a lot of money. I find that this workflow is very useful for e-commerce founders who need marketing materials at scale, or even small business owners who don't have a design team or don't have the budget to hire a design team but want polished, consistent branding. Also, I also think that if you're an agency or you're a marketer and you want to sort of automate certain parts of your creative production for multiple clients, I find that this workflow is also useful for you. And then finally, content creators. Okay, so even if you're a content creator and you want a quick eye-catching visual paired with like ready-to-go captions that you could automate to your social media platforms, then this workflow is also for you. And especially if you're a small business owner or like your marketing agency, you can always use this as drafts to give you some inspiration, and then you can go ahead and design it, right? This is a good place to get inspiration from. So this is good. I'm finally storing this into Google Drive. You don't need to store it in Google Drive. I decided to do that. If you want to store it somewhere else, that's also fine. But yeah, guys, again, in order to store this in Google Drive, you need to make sure that you have like your API keys and everything set up. If you don't have them set up, then you can't really access Google Drive. So make sure that your credentials are set up. Like I always say, like, let me know if you want me to do a tutorial on this part as well, and I'll gladly do so. But yeah, that is it for today's tutorial. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I'll encourage you to do so, so that I can be motivated to keep doing most of these videos. But I'd also like to know, is there anything else you want to see me automate? At this point, I think everything can be automated. But if you think there's anything that can't be automated, just let me know, and then I can try it out on this channel. That is it for today's tutorial. Share, subscribe, comment, like, all the good stuff. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.